Hell Yeah sur la web rock station Vinyl Times, le classic rock radio en direct avec nous, Mr. Martin Van Drunen, notamment du côté des Pays-Bas, qui est le chanteur vocaliste du groupe Hasfix. Hi Martin, how are you?
Bonsoir, ça va?
Oh, bonsoir Monsieur Martin, comment allez-vous?
très bien, très bien, merci. Mais je parle un petit français, mais ça pas suffit pour une interview, alors...
Excellent surprise. Alors là, c'est une excellente surprise. Hi Martin Dog. So, it's a great pleasure to hear you tonight on 213 Rock, Web Rock Station, Vinyl Times Classic Rock Radio. We are located in Paris, France, as you know, and thank you very much for accepting my interview request.
Well, thank you very much for having me on 213 Rock Vinyl Times. It's really nice to be on a show that actually well, let's say like propagate like the times of vinyls, because I still prefer that.
Yes, hell yeah, on the Web Rock Station, man, hell yeah. So, Martin, Hasfix donc sortira son 10e album et nouvel album intitulé Necroceros le 22 janvier prochain via le label Century Media Records notamment. Hasfix is finally back with his 10th studio album entitled Necroceros. It will be released on the January 22. Okay, next year. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. Very heavy album. Oh, I listened all the entire, man. It's heavy, fast, heavy, fast, heavy, 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 fast.
Well, I'm glad you like it that way. I mean, that's what we do it for, right? So, yeah, really pleased to hear that. Thank you.
Yes, yes, yes. Donc, effectivement, vous l'avez compris, hein, l'album sortira le Necroceros le 22 janvier prochain, notamment. C'est très heavy, c'est speed aussi, c'est trash, c'est death par moment. Ça envoie très sévère, c'est aussi technique. Il y a beaucoup de choses à dire, en tout cas. Martin, to begin the promotion, your label Century Media Record has put online Buttocks Implosion. This is the first single from your upcoming album Necroceros, directed by Mr. Maurice Swinkels of Unique Film. Wow.
Yes, exactly. And it's the first single, the first small official video teaser, and we decided to put one on that's a fast shredder in a good old Hasfix tradition. And yeah, with a funny bunch of lyrics, you know, about all these people that need to have like nose corrections or whatever improvement they think are in fact like really not improvements. So in the end, the whole surgery goes wrong and, they end up looking like a daughter or the son of Frankenstein. So I hope people like it.
Effectivement, quoi. Oui, effectivement. Donc, il y a un single qui est déjà sorti. Hein. Le label a commencé par la Century Media pour la promotion du nouvel album, donc Necroceros. Le titre Buttocks Implosion, c'est le premier single notamment. Notamment, ils l'ont tourné avec Mr. Maurice Winkles notamment. Oui, c'est une sorte de Frankenstein, comme il dit. Il y a plein de jokes. C'est assez humoristique en fait. Voilà. Mais musicalement, en tout cas, c'est très, très sévère. Martin, you know what? Because of your track, I have so much hamburger in my hand this afternoon, and then I have a pain on my neck.
Well, that's really good to hear. I mean, that's what this album's supposed to do, huh? I tell you what, when we did the recordings, I had a few severe, like heavy neck injuries myself. So. Yeah, it's good that we can share that with other people.
Ouais, effectivement, cet après-midi en préparant l'interview et tout, donc j'écoutais les titres et tout, j'écoutais l'album en même temps. J'étais en train d'être bangé quand même malade, je me suis retrouvé en train d'être bangé tellement qu'il y a un tempo, il y a un soutien, il y a un rythme incroyable sur ce disque et tout. Et il y a une grosse batterie derrière et tout, ça cogne très très sévère, effectivement. Et je me suis fait mal au cou, effectivement. Je me suis dit, mince. Alors, effectivement, Martin me dit, effectivement, c'est un peu le but de l'album, quoi. C'est pour ça qu'on est là, quoi. Il faut que ça cogne, il faut que c'est sévère, il faut que ça bouge, quoi. Effectivement, c'est ça, quoi. And the clip video is furious, powerful, and there are some scripts ideas. Then we see you on stage.
Yes, because for an Hasfix video, the best thing is to see us on stage. And of course, because it was the lyrics are a little bit funny, we decided to put a few funny elements in it. So me, I am the so-called the patient that has to enjoy it all, and the guys are dressed up as surgeons. And I tell you what, we had a good laugh when we were recording all that stuff. And of course, in the end, you see me like stumbling and running away like an idiot and running from the doctors that are, behind me and want to torture me.
Ce mec est incroyable. Martin Drunel est incroyable, quoi. Je peux vous le dire, c'est vraiment un grand moment ce soir. En fait, oui, effectivement, le clip vidéo est assez fun, comme il le dit. Bon, oui, c'est aussi le but, c'est qu'on nous de nous voir sur scène, notamment. Il y a des, le script est assez marrant, hein, en fait, voilà, sur fond très sérieux et tout, mais en fait, c'est une grosse joke, en fait, comme il dit, c'est vraiment, c'est très très fun, c'est une belle blague en tout cas, mais c'est très bien réalisé, quoi. And behind this, of the clip video, there is a yellow light all the time.
Yes, because it's toxic, right?
Okay. Ah, right. That's right. Effectivement. En fait, voilà, c'est ça. Donc, en fait, ce qu'il y a de bas, c'est que, en fait, il y a tout le temps une lumière jaune qui revient incessamment sous peu. Et voilà, la solution, c'était quoi? C'était la réponse, c'était, c'est toxique. C'est ça. Voilà, quoi. And Martin, the reaction of your fans are great on YouTube.
Yes, really, 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 positively surprised because, especially for our fans, it's not really common that we come out with fast tracks like that. You know, in the past, of course, we had like tracks like Death of Blues Away and Death Hammer, but yeah, we also, it's not really common for us like to do fast tracks. So yeah, in this for this, we're really pleased with the reactions of the people, and also that yeah, they like the video, they liked a little bit of the humorous aspect in it, and well, just, you know, to see that we're, you know, we're human after all. We're not just you know, the brutal kind of you know, that's just that people sometimes think that we are. So, yeah, it's really, really wonderful to hear.
Yes, wonderful. And very 100,000 people going to see this video, nearly. Yeah, it's awesome. Really cool.
I didn't even know it was already that much.
yeah, I saw that, but cool. I saw the comments, everything is fine. Yeah, effectivement, pas loin des 100 000 vues, en tout cas, sur le clip vidéo sorti, quoi, le 6 novembre dernier, c'est-à-dire il y a à peu près 11 jours, notamment, et en même temps, ouais, effectivement, les commentaires sont très bons, quoi, de leurs différents fans, les gens, ils sont contents, ça envoie, les fans de death metal, les fans de trash metal, en tout cas, là-dessus, ils sont tous ensemble, ils sont réunis autour de ce titre, en tout cas, l'album est très prometteur, donc je rappelle, ça s'appelle Necro Ceros, notamment, il sortira le 22 janvier prochain. Finally, this pandemic story about this year, which canceled your tour, but it gave you a lot of time to work on the best possible album.
Yes, exactly. You got that right. Unfortunately, a lot of shows were canceled. Big bummer, because as I said, we are a live band, but what can you do in this situation? You have to make the best out of it. And so we decided to start really working hard and recording the album. And yeah, fortunately, now it's finished. And yeah, we're really pleased with it, and we could put all our time in it. Even during the lockdown here in the Netherlands, when everything was quiet, I could easily concentrate on the lyrics, writing that without being disturbed by anyone. So yeah, that was I say that ouais, making an advantage out of a disadvantage.
Ouais, effectivement, effectivement, cette année, donc la pandémie, vous avez vu, elle a touché beaucoup tout le monde, donc il n'y a pas eu d'exception, effectivement. Donc le groupe a dû annuler sa tournée, effectivement, européenne et d'autres dates, etc. Donc ils avaient à travers l'Europe, etc. Et en même temps, ils se sont donc concentrés sur le nouvel album pour en faire le mieux possible. Ils se sont concentrés sur les lyrics, les paroles, etc. Ils ont essayé de faire du mieux qu'ils pouvaient, et je pense que vous en serez très très récompensés, en tout cas en janvier prochain. And Paul Byans, your guitar player, has released tons of the sick riff on this album.
Yeah, definitely. That must be said. It's very nice, very cool that you noticed that, because yeah, Paul worked hard, and he's just gifted with this, you know, with this that he can fire off any riff, and it just sounds bloody brutal. And yeah, it's a pleasure to have a man like that in a band, in any band. And yeah, he did a fantastic job. He can't ask for more than this. He did an absolute marvelous job.
Ouais, effectivement, Paul Byans, notamment le guitariste du groupe, a proposé des riffs de malade sur ce disque. Ouais, je vous dis, hein, le disque, il riff, ça envoie, c'est sévère, c'est aiguisé, c'est tranchant, c'est le couteau comme ça là. Mais en tout cas, ça tue, quoi. Voilà, comme il l'a dit au début de l'interview, c'est pour ça qu'on l'a fait, quoi. Et c'est pour ça qu'on a mal à la nuque aussi, quoi. And the atmosphere had to be very good between all of you on the studio.
Yes, it's always. Huh? I mean, for us, it's just because in these times we were not able to see each other as much as we usually do because of the shows were not all the shows were cancelled. So now we could see each other in the studio, and we were really pleased to do so. The only little thing was that strange is that because it was really the strict lockdown in the Netherlands, so we had to even keep distance in the studio a little bit. So that was a weird way. But on the other hand, yeah, I think that even, you know, gave us even more motivation to make a fantastic album, really. Right. And yeah, Fortunately, the studio was well isolated, or else the neighbors would have complained, for sure. Or maybe even we would have driven the virus away. Who knows?
Okay. This is it. This is it. This is it. C'est ça. C'est ça. C'est ça. La motivation leur a permis de faire, d'enregistrer le meilleur album possible du moment qu'ils pouvaient donner. C'est ça. Voilà, il l'a dit Martin en direct ce soir, Martin Van Drunen, le chanteur du groupe. Donc, il l'a dit, la motivation à apporter de ce qu'il pouvait de mieux pour le groupe. Et ça, c'est top, quoi. And the first recording of Necrosirus began last year, on November, November 2019.
Yes, exactly, it was first in November. But then after the, when we heard the songs, we were, you know, we thought like, there's still something missing, you know. So, the main stuff was actually done, about six tracks or something, but we were not really super happy with it at the time. So we knew, we had to shape a little bit more, and that's why we decided to go back into the studio and do a new jam. And then that's when everything fell to the pieces, and all the songs were ready, and boom, there we went.
Ouais,
from there on it was easy.
Ouais, effectivement, quoi. Les premiers enregistrements, donc, ont commencé, ont débuté en novembre dernier. Ils ont terminé, bon, bien après, effectivement, ils ont eu le temps de le faire. Voilà, il l'a dit encore. Ils ont eu vraiment le temps de le faire. C'est top cool, quoi. And, about the song Mount School, Knights Templar Stands and 3 Years of Famine, 3 tracks, a heavy and melodic atmosphere in the middle of the album.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely. But there's also, you know, that's where you go. That's where Paul comes into place again. You know, there's just he keeps on firing off these fantastic riffs, and also with the difference in the songs. You know, like 3 Years of Famine is really melodic, melancholic, but still ultra heavy. And the Templars is it's a more like an up tempo song about the Templars went to the so-called Promised Land to protect the Pilgrims and battle the Saracens. And they fought till the death, so it's a bit of a story about bravery. Mount Skull is a very traditional Asterix song, starting with a slow driving riff and going really fast in the center, and you go back to the slow driving riff again. And the lyrics of 3 Years of Famine is because the song is so very sad that I had to make a good topic of it. And so I decided to take on the great Chinese famine under Mao. Where almost like 40-45 million people, still rough estimated, died terribly under a horrible regime. Mm-hmm. So and that's because that was the only topic in my vision that really covered the load of the song, because Paul did a fantastic job on that one.
Ouais.
Unbelievable.
Effectivement. Sur cet album, il y a 3 titres comme ça qui se suivent, notamment donc le Mount Skull, le Knights Templar Stand, le 3 Years of Famine. Ces 3 titres-là sont super heavy et mélodiques en même temps. C'est pas pour rien qu'ils les ont mis là, en tout cas. Il faut juste écouter tout l'album. Pourquoi? Parce qu'il y a des titres assez rapides et d'autres beaucoup plus heavy, effectivement. Et au milieu, il y a une atmosphère qui s'installe, il y a une ambiance comme ça qui s'écoule, et avec des thèmes bien différents, notamment dans 3 Years of Famine, notamment qui parle de l'époque chinoise, de Mao, où il y a eu énormément de millions de morts à cause de la famine. C'est un sujet donc que Martin aime et apprécie de parler. Il souhaitait donc échanger avec les fans, effectivement, qui écouteront ce titre. Et là, c'est vraiment cool, quoi. C'est vraiment très, très cool, quoi. And Martin, Necrosirus was recorded at the Tom Mayer Studio and the Morcerer Studio, mixed and mastered by Mr. Sebastian Sib Leverman.
Yes, exactly. So there's 2 studios. The one is the one of Tommy. He's a good friend engineer of ours, and he lives not far away from here. So that's the studio we use for the drums and for my vocals, and all the guitars were in the Paul's Mercer studio, which is at home, recorded, because it's, you know, it's the most comfortable way to do that. And yes, we took a different approach with the mix with call him Zabe, Sebastian Edelman, and yeah, he did a fantastic job. It was a pleasure to work with him. He was really enthusiastic, really passionate metalhead. We gave him the chance. He took the chance, and he did a marvelous job. We're absolutely, we're delighted with the outcome of it. It sounds incredibly heavy. It has a kind of an atmosphere. He really knew to deal well with my vocals, and to be quickly sure that people. please don't misunderstand us. It's not because we weren't satisfied with Dan Swano, because we used to work with him in the past, and Dan is a fantastic professional mixer. It's fantastic also to work with him. He's also a good friend of the band. But for this album, we just decided to put something fresh in it, and we thought, maybe the mix would be a part of that. And so it's not that people think, they're not happy with Dan Swano. On the contrary, no. But we just wanted to try something new out, and in this case, it worked really well.
Effectivement, donc l'album a été enregistré en deux parties dans les studios, donc au studio Tom Meyer et notamment, et au Morse Studio notamment, donc c'est un choix bien défini qu'il vient de décrire, et en même temps le mix a été plus loin et le mastering avec Sébastien Lem notamment. Par le passé, ils ont travaillé avec Dan Swano, ils s'entendent toujours très bien, donc là-dessus on est très clair, Martin est très clair là-dessus, ils s'entendent toujours très bien, mais ils voulaient une nouvelle approche, quelque chose de nouveau, quelque chose de beaucoup plus frais, ils voulaient quelqu'un avec de l'enthousiasme, et notamment donc c'est Sébastien Sib Leverman, quelqu'un d'enthousiasme, un vrai metalhead, un passionné en tout cas, qui leur a fait quelques mix notamment, qui a fait quelques essais, et ça a été concluant quoi. C'est ce qu'ils aiment. Ils ont obtenu ce qu'ils voulaient très exactement. Sébastien a très bien compris, et ça là-dessus, c'est juste cool. Et voilà, donc, et ça a donné Necroceros. C'est vraiment un disque, comme je vous dis, furieux, heavy, atmosphérique. Il y a de tout dedans en tout cas. Il y en a pour tous les goûts, et c'est vraiment très très bon quoi. And the art, about the artwork was released by Mr. Axel Herrmann.
Yes, of course, an Asphyx album has to have the artwork of Axel, and once more he did it marvelously, and it also surprised us in a positive way, because usually all the covers that he makes have this dark thing, and this time he used this it's almost you can almost like smell the stench of this poisonous green kind of mist, you know, that's hanging like in there, and he just he did a fantastic job. I only gave him like the interpretation of what a Necrosaurus could eventually look like, and you know, left it all to his imagination, and once more he did it marvelously. So mm-hmm. he's you know, the artwork of Axel is has always been part of Asphyx since the very very beginning.
Ok, effectivement, donc la pochette a été réalisée, l'artwork a été réalisé par Mr. Axel Herrmann. Il a très très bien capté toutes les idées qu'avait le groupe concernant Necroceros, le prochain album, et donc il a très très bien compris, et il a fait une pochette vraiment effrayante quoi. I'm really afraid about your artwork.
That's how it should be, right?
Oh yeah. Oh man.
This artwork is like the personification of the COVID-19.
Ok, effectivement, ouais. La pochette, elle est vraiment effrayante, quoi. C'est un peu l'imagerie du COVID-19, comme il le dit. Ouais, c'est très, très effrayant, quoi. And do you know what? Do you know what? The good news is the first version of Necroceros is already sold out. I'm talking about the limited deluxe gatefold, dark green, yellow, white, and splattered with two LPs. This is it.
Yeah. Wow, it's already sold out, yeah?
Yeah.
Wow, that's fantastic news, especially because in France everything is even more locked down than anywhere else, but
yes.
I think in most countries the record stores unfortunately are closed, so this means that people have to obtain it online, and it's incredible that that it's already sold out. Cool.
Ouais, effectivement. Cool.
But I must say that this one is if it's the gatefold deluxe, it's really a special edition. It's really beautiful made, really.
Ouais, effectivement.
We put a lot of work into it.
Ouais. Effectivement, notamment une très très belle édition de luxe qui est déjà sold out notamment, mais d'autres arriveront hein, notamment. Vous pouvez d'ores et déjà aller sur le site asphyx.nl notamment, aller voir ce que propose le groupe notamment. Il y a du merchandising, il y a des t-shirts, il y a tout, et il peut y avoir des précommandes concernant encore le prochain album. Il y a d'autres éditions limited qui vont arriver, notamment CD plus DVD, il y a un media book, il y a un deluxe LP DVD, et l'album sortira aussi en digital. Martin Van Drunen est avec nous ce soir en direct sur 213 Rock Vinnie Times, le Classic Rock Radio. L'album sortira le 22 janvier prochain, notamment via le label Century Media Records. Voici le track listing. L'album démarra donc avec The Soul Curse is Death, Molten Black Earth, en 3 Mount Skull, en 4 Knights Templar Stand, en 5 Three Years of Famine, en 6 Button Implosion, ça c'est le single, en 7 In Blazing Oceans, en 8 The Nameless Elite, en 9 Yield or Die en 10, Necroceros. Le line-up, Martin van Drunen au chant, Paul Byans notamment à la guitare, Alwin Zur à la basse et Stefan Juskens notamment à la batterie. C'est énorme en tout cas. Ce soir, Martin van Drunen est avec nous. Il est en forme, vous l'entendez, c'est juste génial. Martin, I hope we will be to see you on stage in France or some great festival in next 2 years.
Yeah, thank you very much. We hope the same too. And we don't know when this is will be over. So fingers crossed. Hopefully, the vaccine will help to stop, you know, to battle the virus really quickly, and so everything can back to normal, and we can play live. We can shred or you can enjoy yourselves watching Asphyx. Thank you.
Ouais, effectivement, vous l'avez entendu. Donc, ils espèrent qu'il va y avoir un vaccin. Ils espèrent que tout va s'arranger et qu'on va pouvoir reprendre enfin nos vies telles qu'elles étaient auparavant. Ça, là-dessus, on croise vraiment les doigts, quoi. Martin, do you have a message for the audience tonight, please?
Yes, I have a message to all the French who are listeners, the metalheads. First of all, thanks very, very much for all the support for Asphyx during the years. Be sure that when COVID is battled, that we come to France to do a few shows, and then we see each other and we can drink a beer or a wine and enjoy your fantastic French food. And I'd like to thank you all for the support, and especially be safe, hang in there. This shit will go away, and you know we have to stand strong and united. We will be.
Yes, yes, yes.
Thanks. Yes. Merci beaucoup.
Merci beaucoup, Martin. Just one thing, Martin. You know, the Webrock Station Vinyl Times Classic Rock Radio, we are distributed by Amazon. This is the Webrock Station, and every night we are touching some countries. We have the audience from France, of course. We have some people from Portugal, from Spain, Italia, Turkey, and Tunisia, Algeria, Morocco, Italian people. Yes, every night it's amazing. Really, it's amazing.
Fantastic.
Yes.
That's fantastic. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I was already thinking, you know, because France, of course, has a lot of, you know, countries where they speak the language. So I was thinking,
right.
Well, maybe you broadcast also in the countries where, yeah, you know, you still have like a large population speaking French. You
yeah.
Know, even, not even like northern, you know, Algeria or Libya, but also, you know, countries like Guyana or, you know, the overseas like Guadeloupe or something. You know?
And you know what? Metal is everywhere. Heavy metal is everywhere.
That's why I said, like, united we stand and divided we fall. And metal is indeed, like you say, it's universal. It's
yes,
universal.
Yes.
That's the wonderful thing about it.
Yeah. And my last word is there is a big community of metal, heavy metal, death metal, black metal in Algeria, in Morocco, Tunisia, and the rest of the world, man. You believe me, there is a lot of metalhead and they are listening. A lot of people know your band.
Thank you very much. That's really a pleasure to hear, because sometimes, you know, from quite a few countries, of course, but I wouldn't have no idea how many. I mean, I met once a guy from Morocco, and he said it was not really very safe there to walk around in death metal shirts or something, you know, so I was quite shocked. But yeah, it's really cool to hear that there is a scene out there, or even there's a scene in Algeria, because I had no idea really.
No, it's very cool. People are very fun, very smart, nice people. They know metal, exactly what metal is, you know. They are perfectly, they know the bands, they have magazines, smartphone, everything. They speak English, they have a very good English, people are very intelligent, nice people, nice community, really, nice community.
Yeah, beautiful. That's fantastic. You know, that's really wonderful to hear. I mean, I couldn't wait to, you know, to play one of these countries, because we've never been there.
Yeah.
Course, you know?
Okay.
So, yeah.
Ok, donc vous l'avez entendu.
Fantastic.
Fantastique. Vous l'avez entendu, c'était Martin van Drunen ce soir. On a parlé notamment des communautés, etc., qui est dans le métal. Effectivement, le métal est partout, et même là où on ne l'attend pas, en tout cas. C'est ça la classe, quoi. Martin van Drunen, thank you very much for the interview tonight. Thank you very much, really. It was a great pleasure.
Thank you very much, Herrick, and... Yeah, it was for me. It was a pleasure too. You know, I had to get used quickly a bit. You know, because it's online radio. You know, you're live. So yeah, you have to deal with that. But it was really a pleasure. Thank you very much. And a big thanks to all the listeners. And like I said, as you say in French, courage. Things will get better.
Tout de suite en musique, Botox Implosion, Asphyx, le nouvel album Necroceros qui sortira le 22 janvier prochain. 213 Rock. Ha ha ha! Hell yeah, sur la Web Rock Station, Vinny Times, le Classic Rock Radio, Asphyx, Bottom, Implosion, Martin Van Drunen qui était avec nous en direct. Tout de suite, continuons en musique avec le Orienti, le Contagious et le Butch Rock juste derrière. 213 Rock.